You see that guy on stage giving a TED Talk? That's me. You see this guy screaming his lungs out at a metal show? That's also me. Oh, and that's my dog. Not sure how that got in there.
If we consistently interrupt our old thought patterns with new ones and we resist the urge to judge ourselves for how long this process takes, we won't waste our lives waiting around for a eureka moment that might never come.
I'm Johnny Crowder, and it's not always easy to fit me in a box. But maybe that's not such a bad thing, because for the past jillion years, mental health has felt like a taboo, boxed-up topic. And I'm here to unbox it.
Growth takes time. Lots of it. We can't just work out on Saturday and expect to look like The Rock on Sunday. I mean, think about it. We'd never ask WWE superstar Dwayne The Rock Johnson, can you tell us about the one push-up that got you into the shape you're in today? We would never do that. We know that physical change is complicated and it takes time. So why do we expect mental and emotional change to happen instantly?
Be honest, when I say mental health, what do you picture? Someone sniffling in a therapist's office, clutching a box of tissues? A bunch of people holding hands, singing Kumbaya? For me, I think of leadership, culture, attracting and retaining top talent, work-life balance, resilience, overcoming compassion fatigue, and kicking burnout's butt, using the hard things that happen in our lives to springboard us to new heights. At least that's what it looked like for me. I didn't just survive abuse, depression, and suicide. I've thrived in a way that I doubt I could have, even if I won the genetic lottery. Yes, I have a psychology degree and some letters after my name. Yes, I created a mental health resource that provides daily support to people like you and me all over the world. And yes, we've won a bunch of awards for being awesome at doing that. I've been profiled on CNN and Forbes, charted on Billboard and blah, 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 but you can find all of that stuff on Google. You wanna know what actually gives me the authority to turn your conference, your retreat, your culture into something that people will still be talking about 10 years from now? Not my tattoos. Not my humor, it's my lived experience.
What I care a lot about is reminding people that it's not that you can't overcome negativity bias, it's that the volume of your combatant thoughts needs to be greater. So if you have one negative thought, you might need 11 positive thoughts to overcome it. It's not that it can't be overcome, it's that you really need to put in some work on the other side.
I don't just talk the talk, I've been through it firsthand, and my story has touched millions of brains and hearts across the globe as a result. My whole job is to use the awful things I've been through to drive radical change in the lives of other people. And your whole job is to put together the greatest event in the history of the universe. I can help with that. I know I'm not your typical suit and tie, stick to the PowerPoint keynote speaker. I'll admit it, I'm a different cup of tea. But if you really care about your audience, you're probably looking for something different anyway. And if nothing else, when you invite a literal mental health rock star to the stage, I can promise you exactly that. Something different.